I don't name the videos that I do, but this one should be named A Bird in the Hand, and with all logo being a bird, so it has a double meaning to it. That is, I worked with a homeowner a year ago. I made an offer on her house. My offer was very close to her highest offer, a few thousand dollars less. I showed proof of funds. I have a pedigree, I have a history of, at this point, 15 years in this business. And she really liked and wanted to work with me, but she went with somebody else for literally a few thousand dollars more. I don't think it was even $10,000. On the price of a whole house, I mean, that's a lot of money, but on the price of a whole house and getting it done, it may not be so much, and it turned out to be not so much. A year has gone by, and she just called me, is my offer still good? Unfortunately, my offer is no good. I don't ever renege on an offer. A year later is a very long time. But in that time, there was a major change with her next door neighbor. And that would have been my problem. But the house is no longer has the value it has now. Not important what went on with the next door neighbor, what they ended up doing to that property, but it's devalued her house tremendously. And after a year, that other buyer never materialized. He never delivered. He strung her along for the entire year. And for some reason, she kept with him. I have no idea why she was so patient, but as a result, she lost him and she lost me. And I've never, as I said, I've never backed down from a price. A year's a long time. And I would even have held my price in spite of the fact that at this point of the time, we're at the peak of the market, but I don't like to not hold the price almost forever if I can. But again, the situation changed and the house is no longer what it was worth a year ago. So I was the bird in the hand. I had proof of funds. We could have closed in just a few weeks. This person had to jump through hoops to get financing, and she told me one financing source fell through after another, after another, after another. He had never, ever actually purchased a house before. It was his first house, and she thought it was worth a few thousand dollars extra, and it turned out it wasn't, and she doesn't know what she's gonna do now, but she's not gonna get the money I offered her for the house a year ago. And she's now looking for that same amount of money again. But she's probably gonna blow it all over again, and I feel terrible. And so again, the moral of the story is a bird in the hand. Don't always go for the best dollar, go for the best value, which is the price, the quality of the company and the person you're dealing with, the expedience in which they can close, and how convenient they are to you. Do they able to accommodate what it is that you need, whether it's timetable or whatever it might be. So, well, leaving your stuff behind or whatever. There's many issues that can be. So again, always focus on the big picture, not just on price.